Hi everyone, so today we're going to be talking about metaphors. And a metaphor is a comparison between two things in order to highlight their similarities and evoke deeper meaning. In other words, one thing is said to be another. So for example, the bubbles in the river were silk balloons. Her eyes were emeralds, piercing and bright. The clouds are spun sugar. The lightning was a wizard's wand. So you can see that these metaphors are quite evocative and they help us to see these things in a deeper, richer way. Now I'm going to read from my book, The Scent of Eucalyptus, which is available on Amazon, iTunes and Kobo. This poem is called Heaven on Earth. Listen out for the metaphors. A steel bird flies through violet skies, the clouds spun sugar, tinged with plum. He hurtles on towards his goal, his passenger's journey just begun. Beneath the nimbus lightning strikes, a sparkling silver fairy's wand. The fuchsia light, canary hues, their unadulterated bond. I cannot turn my eyes transfixed, the clouds tears heavenly waterfalls. The empathetic land below, the thunder, his reprimanding calls. I rest my hands on metal rail, the swirling sky is mystical. Its powerful presence dominates, I'd call it egotistical. Why is each sunset so unique, refracted light our planets spin? The dust a scene creates, my obsession causing slight chagrin. To capture one to freeze in time, of magic bottles there is a dearth. Yet I'm so thankful, don't you see, as they're quite simply heaven on earth. So, if you heard the metaphors, well done. Now, I'm going to read them out for you, and you see if you identify them correctly. The clouds spun sugar, tinged with plum. Now, I haven't used the verb to be because it's a poem, but the clouds are being likened to spun sugar. Beneath the nimbus lightning strikes a sparkling silver fairy's wand. So the lightning is being compared with a silver fairy's wand. It's quite magical, isn't it? The next one, the clouds tears heavenly waterfalls. So the rain, or the clouds tears, is being compared with waterfalls or heavenly waterfalls. You can just visualize that, can't you, if you've ever been to a natural waterfall. So I hope you enjoyed this, and if you'd like, you can write a story or a poem that contains different metaphors in order to draw the reader into your story, to make it more evocative, and to evoke deeper meaning. Good luck.